We talked about, not on here before, but on the newsletter before, when Loom launched in July. It's a social media, well, no, not social media, a music streaming platform / social media platform where it's only for independent artists. It's not, there's no major label catalogs on there, no independent labels on there. It's purely just for independent artists marketing their music. And it's only in the US right now, but it's a good way to discover local acts and smaller artists and support them. And they're now launching their own sort of like virtual gifting currency in January, you know, in this month coming. So you'll be able to actually tip artists using this currency called notes, where, you know, you can pay to help them support, launch their next EP, or, you know, get this demo made to a proper track. That's just a great way to engage with artists and support them in their careers.
And what I love about this one is obviously the money that the artist stands to make, because if we look at the revenue sharing model of a Spotify, those types of distribution platforms, now, not only do you have to make that go through that entire split situation, but a lot of artists don't even realize that it's not directly based on your streams, right? You're still in this pool. And of course, that's that. If you're comparing your streams to Drake streams and the collective stream, right, and you're dividing by that, so ever more you're going to be a smaller number, stand a chance to get your maximum value on that platform, because mm-hmm. you're being juxtaposed with people you shouldn't even be juxtaposed with, as a matter of fact, the collection of them. So that's one point. But then also, all streams aren't even created equal. What you get promoted is the average, right, of payout. But free Spotify listeners, their streams aren't the same as paid Spotify listeners. It's not equal or worth the same. And there's all these other nuances, which I'm not completely privy to, of how they determine what a user's particular stream. My stream might not be worth your stream, right? So you don't get paid. So your fan base might not even be the most profitable fan base. You know what I mean? I see plenty of artists who talk about their numbers and they even their actual streams in terms of, not their streams, the payout that they got from Spotify. As a matter of fact, I know a few, I'm going to hit them up and ask them to do this. I want them to calculate their payout based on the average of what the payout is promoted as and see how close they are, all right? And that'll be where we start to get artists to understand what the payout is. But I know I kind of went to the, that was more of an aside, but that's why the tipping feature is so valuable. Because if you look at TikTok, right, that's the beauty of TikTok. We're now seeing China's influence, because tipping, badges, in-app purchases, like that's so native and so profitable over there. When we look at just all of these platforms in China, like so many of their social platforms,
WeChat,
that's killing it. That's not ingrained in American culture as of now. And TikTok is bringing that in a very real way. Where that's a norm. And that makes it so much easier, though, for a social media platform, because we always looked at a standpoint as the only way we're going to monetize, for the most part, has been through advertisement. This allows you to scale far bigger and to become profitable faster without even having to worry about the whole advertisement thing, which brings in more corporate influence, which is why most of our apps get like up, they're big. And then, okay, now you start to see this monetization thing that starts to kill the experience. You're able to have a better user experience longer, at least, right? It maybe extends the lifespan of a good quality experience because of different ways to monetize. So that's going to be interesting to see.
Good thing about Loom as well is that it's, at the moment, it's free to use if you're an artist or you're a user, and also unlimited uploads as well to the platform. So you can put as much music on there as you want. And obviously, it only launched in July. I remember we talked about when it first came along. We thought, is it going to be another one of those platforms, you know, flash in the pan, gets a bit of funding, but doesn't really do anything. But a few of your artists have used it on the network, haven't they, as well? So I think we've had some, you know, fairly decent results. People on Twitter, I've seen a lot, been following the accounts for Loom and the feedback. It seems very positive and overall. So I think it might be sticking around for a while.
Yeah, I mean, they're still early on, right? There's a lot of market share to grab, but. Yeah. Every artist and brand and network that's really got a chance to use it, they're only on iOS, as a reminder to people. Everyone that's gotten a chance to use it so far has had a pretty positive experience, and they actually go back to some of the things that we've talked about earlier. Not only are they doing the tipping feature that they just released, but they're a social interactive space, right? Mm-hmm. So you have that chance to engage with fans where Spotify started and they shifted away from, and now they created a space where these people can capitalize, right? And they were supposed to be music discovery, and they kind of, and they didn't do well enough. So TikTok is kind of fulfilling that void, and Loom, it seems they're building into a space where we can truly handle this social interaction. But of course, Rezo is kind of trying to do the same thing, but there's mm-hmm. at least a joint acknowledgement that social is an aspect of music, and they're so closely ingrained is they shouldn't have to be separate. At the very least, between Loom and Rezo, you might see this whole idea, if Loom stays within its philosophy, where Loom becomes this place. And I spoke to people at Loom, Andre, I believe, that was the one who said that Loom is kind of positioning themselves as they care about artists who are just starting out, right? Those indie yeah. artists, and yeah. truly sticking to that, where they don't even necessarily need you to be on there forever. They don't necessarily want Drake to be on the platform.
That's the impression right? I got as well, yeah.
Right. Yeah. So, but you can become, like, be a part of becoming Drake on the platform, and mm-hmm. then you might go really start to do a business dealings and things like that in another way. Some of that, you know, you watch and see as more people get on the platform, how what they continue to see to read and how they evolve. But the fact that they're staying within that particular philosophy, which is so different than we want to have the big music and deal with the labels in that particular aspect, will force them to innovate in a way that other companies don't. So I'm really rooting for Loom and interested to watch what they create, and if for no reason at all, but a business experiment.
Yeah, if you're in the US and you've got an iPhone, definitely download it and start using it, like 100%. Because obviously it only launched in July. It's already got 30,000 artists on there and over 50,000 tracks. And they have said they're going to launch, you know, more worldwide in this coming year. And also hopefully, you know, I launched an Android as well. So it should only be a matter of time before they continue to grow. It's just slowly rolling things out, but definitely check it out.
Mm. Yep.